Hello everyone. You might tune into our YouTube channel from time to time to see a sermon's 30 minutes or so. Today at the Midvale Church of Christ, because of Easter, we did things a little differently. We had a collection of readings from Scripture that told the story of what Jesus has done for us. We began with reading and being reminded of our need for saving from our sin, and then that Jesus came and that he was welcomed as a king, but then he was quickly betrayed and went to death on a cross. He was crucified, he was buried, and raised to new life again. And then he ascended back to the Father. And so today our scripture readings were recorded, and hopefully you'll be able to hear them okay, and the various men and young men that read those for us today. So the video that you'll see isn't a sermon, but it's a collection of readings to tell that story of Jesus and what he did for us. We also had an Easter egg hunt today, and a bunch of kids had a great time looking around for buried treasure today. We talked about why we look for eggs on Easter, and one of the little kids said it best. The Easter egg is kind of like the empty tomb, and Jesus is the candy that comes out. And so we were celebrating new life through Jesus and his sacrifice and his resurrection for us today. So enjoy this video. Thank you. The fool says in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They do abominable deeds. There is none who does good. The Lord looks down from heaven on the children of man to see if there are any who understand, who seek after God. They have all turned aside. Together they have become corrupt. There is none who does good, not even one. Have they no knowledge, all the evildoers who eat up my people as they eat bread, and do not call upon the Lord? There they are in great terror, for God is with the generation of the righteous. You would shame the plans of the poor, but the Lord is his refuge. Oh, that salvation for Israel would come out of Zion, when the Lord restores the fortunes of his people. Let Jacob rejoice. Let Israel be glad.
City of Zion, people of joy. People through him shout. See your king comes to you. He always does what is right. He has won the victory. He is humble and riding on a donkey. He is sitting on a donkey's colt. This day, the large crowd that had come for feast heard of that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. So they took branches from palm trees and went out to meet him. They shouted, Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel.
Then came the day of unleavened bread, when the Passover must be killed. And he sent Peter and John, saying, Go and prepare the Passover for us. What we may eat. So they said to him, Where do you want us to prepare? And he said to them, Behold, when you have entered the city, a man will meet you carrying a pitcher of water. Follow him into the house which he enters. Then you shall say to the master of the house, The teacher says to you, Where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples? Then he will show you a large furnished upper room. There, make it ready. So they went and found it just as he had said to them, and they prepared for Passover. Let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, as we humbly bow before you, we thank you for this opportunity we have to take of this bread that represents your Son who was sacrificed for our sins. We pray that as each one of us partake of it, that we do so in a manner that is you approve of, that we reflect on not only the sins that we've committed, but we ask for forgiveness, and we ask for you to give us guidance to help us to be better Christians and to reflect on that ultimate sacrifice that was given for us, not just for us to think lightly of each week, but for us to reflect on and think of a life that not only suffered, but was given for everyone. We thank you for this opportunity we have. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Just as he was speaking, Judah, one of the twelve, appeared. With them as a crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the teachers of the law and the elders. Now the betrayer has angered a single with them. The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard. Going at once to Jesus, Judah said, Rabbi, and kissed him.
For many bore false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. And some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying, We heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made with hands. Yet even about this, their testimony did not agree.
When the hour had come, he sat down, the 12 apostles with him. Then he said to them, With fervent desire, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say to you, I will no longer eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. Then he took the cup and gave thanks and said, Take this and divide it amongst yourselves. For I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took the bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, This is my body, which I give for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, he took the cup after supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you.
Let's pray together. Our Lord and our God, we are so thankful that we are here today. We're thankful that we can come together as one body, in one spirit, in one mind, worshiping you, singing songs of praise to you, hearing about the wonderful story about your Son coming down to this earth and what he did for us. Father, as we kneel at the cross, as we see your Son hanging on the cross, we now reflect upon his shed blood that represents forgiveness. We're thankful for this fruit of the vine that we can take that reminds us that it's your Son, Jesus Christ's blood, that washes away our sins. And we're so thankful that we can come together each week and worship you and remember our purpose here. Father, thank you that you're a loving God, that you took care of us, that you always look out for us, Father, and that this perfect plan of salvation is for all. As we reflect upon this fruit of the vine, Father, help us to keep our minds on the cross. In your Son's name we pray. Amen.
He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hid their faces, he was despised, and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took upon our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted, but he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all like sheep have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of all of us. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as the sheep before its shearer is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away. Yet two of his generation protested. For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgressions of my people he was punished. He was assigned a grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life an offering for sin, he will see his offspring and prolong his days. And the will of the Lord will prosper in his hand. After he has suffered, he will see the light of life and be satisfied by his knowledge. My righteous servant will justify many, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore I will give him a portion among the great, and he will divide the spoils with the strong, because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors. For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors.
On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again.'"
Then Jesus led them to Bethany, and lifting his hands to heaven, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he left them as he was taken up to heaven. So they worshiped him, and they returned to Jerusalem, filled with great joy. And they spent all of their time in the temple, praising God. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, today we celebrate Easter. Some of us may think it's about jelly beans or peeps or Easter baskets, but it's about your Son and his sacrifice. As days go by, we may think we're Job as we go through the highs and lows of life. We may think that we're Solomon and how wise we are. Or we may think of the giants that we've slain like David, but we will never know the sacrifice that Jesus gave for us that day. May we rise today from this church and go out and be servant leaders just as Jesus was, so that we know one day we will see you in heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.